My first guest today is editorial board member Mary Kissel. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me, Jason.
To discuss this latest housing plan by the Obama administration. So am I being too cynical here? Is this latest $26 billion settlement announced today just another effort to keep people in homes that they really can't afford to be in?
I think that's a great summary. Another way to put it is that we had politicized lending get us into the housing crisis. We had a boom and a bust, and now we have politicized settlements that are probably going to create another housing crisis based on more politicized lending.
So what can you tell us about this settlement? $26 billion, a huge amount of money. What's it going to go toward?
Well, the excuse for the settlement was the robo-signing scandal that erupted at the end of 2010.
And what is robo-signing?
Robo-signing is just a description of sloppy paperwork practices by banks when they were going to foreclose. Now, normally, federal regulators would go into banks, examine them, look at their procedures, tell them how to fix them, and then levy fines for the people who were harmed, if any. Which is exactly what the federal regulators did. But a group of very, very activist state attorneys general, HUD and others in the Obama administration, spotted basically political gold. And they said, look, we can use this to squeeze money out of banks for our own political purposes. So that's exactly what you saw today. Out of this $26 billion number, only $1.6 billion of that is going to alleged victims of robo-signing. And I say alleged victims because it's never been proven that people were kicked out of their homes who didn't deserve to be kicked out
of
their homes.
It's hard to find some of these victims that we see being used as sort of poster children for what they're trying to do here.
Yeah, where are the victims? People who are current on their mortgage who were wrongfully kicked out of their house. There aren't any. So where is the bulk of this money going? It's going to reward people who are not paying their mortgages and are in homes whose loans are worth more than the value of the house. It's going to people who can afford to pay their mortgages, but again, whose homes are worth more than the value on the house, so they just made bad bets. It's going to keep unemployed borrowers who can't afford their homes in their homes. It's giving money to state and federal authorities to distribute as they see fit. It's giving money to community groups who are then backing the political campaigns, mostly of Democrats. This is an extraordinary day.
So, and again, banks will be required not only to reduce interest payments, but principal. Banks will have to take losses on some of these loans.
Yeah, look, there's no free lunch. Ohio Attorney General Tom Miller, who's been one of the forces behind these negotiations and political arm twisting, suggested today that there was a free lunch, and people like us who suggested that, you know, the money has to come from somewhere just didn't understand what they were doing, and he had to explain it better. But the reality is, yes, somebody takes the loss. It's investors, it's bank shareholders.
And that second group you named, I mean, some of this money will go to people who are actually behind in their payments or are unable to make payments. But a bunch of this money is going to go to people who are current, who can currently afford to pay their mortgages and, in fact, are paying their mortgages, correct?
Yeah, and where's the equity in this? So government is just going to pick, oh, I think I'm going to take money from these people and give it to these other people? Look, all this is going to do, Jason, is stall foreclosures, which is only going to prolong the housing crisis. We saw it happen in the Bush administration right at the end when the housing market crashed, and we saw it continue through the Obama administration. This does not help homeowners.
What will help homeowners? How do we get out of this housing mess, Mary?
If anything, you have to speed foreclosures. It's an awful thing to say. It's very painful.
No one likes to see someone
Nobody
lose their
likes
home.
To see this, but the housing market will never clear, and we will never see a recovery until we get rid of this oversupply of homes and we get people into these houses who can actually afford to pay the rent.
And there needs to be consequences in place for people who make bad decisions. I mean, the right incentives need to be in place in a free market system.
Yeah, look, ultimately, the goal of this White House is to make housing a right, just like health care. So you can't view this robo-signing settlement just by itself. You have to view it in part of this larger package of trying to force the Federal Housing Administration, which is insolvent, to back private loans, of trying to force Fannie and Freddie's regulator, who has been trying to protect taxpayers, to force him to do principal write-downs, which he doesn't want to do. It's part of this larger vision that the housing lobby has always advocated for, which is that doesn't matter if you can't afford it, we want to give it to you.
Bottom line, this probably is not the silver bullet to the housing crisis. We'll see what happens. But thank you, Mary.
Thanks for having me.